We're going to start our 2011-2012 season with an exciting, funny, romantic comedy from the 17th century called The Liar. However, it's adapted by one of America's cleverest and funniest playwrights, David Ives, known for All in the Timing. Very funny man. He's taken this romantic comedy about somebody who cannot stop lying in the pursuit of the perfect woman, and he's turned this kind of verse that's poetic and 17th century into kind of wacky contemporary verse too. So it's a wonderful way to start the season. Up in the stage will be To Kill a Mockingbird by Christopher Sergel, obviously based on Harper Lee's famous novel. This is, I think, one of the most authentic views of the American South, and of course a novel that lives in our hearts and minds, one of the great novels of the 20th century. We'll be doing this adaptation that has an adult scout, the voice of Harper Lee, on stage. In the Ricketson, we're going to bring a group to Denver that's never been here that I think will be very exciting, The Culture Clash, a Latino trio of comedians. They write their own shows. Richard Montoya and The Culture Clash wrote American Night, which was the hit of the Oregon Shakespeare Festival season last year. It's a very funny, provocative, wild ride. It's a night when a Latino man is studying for his American history test before his naturalization process the next day, and all these characters from American history show up, and they provide him with an alternative view of American history. Very funny. Features two of the Culture Clash members, Richard Montoya and Herbert Seguenza, will play in the Ricketson in the fall.
Does that make it more or less likely they're going to pass their test?
I don't know if he's going to pass his test after this, but he's certainly going to have a different view. In the Space Theater, in the holiday slot, roughly, we'll be doing The Adventures of Tom Sawyer by Denver native Laura Eason, based on the famous novel by Mark Twain. We're happy to say that this is bringing back the family series middle school production. It'll feature 14 student matinees and plenty of performances for adults, for the families, for audiences of all ages. I love this story because it's about the quintessential American boy. It's also about coming of age. An American boy has to decide, is he going to do the right thing and tell everybody, no, he's not dead, and make sure the wrong man doesn't go to the gallows. So it's a great story and an American classic.
Kent, I did a high school play with Laura Eason.
Oh, you did?
It was an original creation piece that covered the history of the world from the Big Bang until the 60s race riots.
All right. How long was the piece?
It was about 3.5 hours.
There you go.
I think that's why Laura Eason left Colorado. Yeah,
could be. In the holidays, we'll be bringing back our spectacular, gorgeous musical production of A Christmas Carol, adapted by Richard Hellison with music by David DeBerry from the Charles Dickens novella that really changed the way we celebrate Christmas in the modern world. In the winter, I'm very excited to announce our world premieres. The first world premiere is by one of America's most exciting young writers, Samuel D. Hunter, called The Whale. This is an almost impossible play to describe. It's a tough play, but it's very moving. It's about a morbidly obese man who became obese following the death of his partner and the collapse of his marriage because it came out that he was gay. He's now trying to reconnect with his daughter, teenage daughter, before he fears that he may die. And it's an improbable idea of this man living in a trailer in Idaho, coming to terms with his life, but it's so moving by the end. It's really an extraordinary piece of writing for the American theater. Two Things You Don't Talk About at Dinner by one of America's leading female playwrights and also one of America's funniest writers. This is about a Seder dinner in Los Angeles that has a multicultural group of friends, family members, where everything goes wrong. It's very funny. It's also very sobering because they talk about the two things you're not supposed to talk about, religion and politics. Specifically the Israeli-Palestinian conflict, but all kinds of religion and politics. Very funny play, very American. The Shakespeare for this year will be The Taming of the Shrew by William Shakespeare. I'm particularly happy to be directing this knockabout battle of the sexes. And I'll say up front, I'm going to set it in the 1950s America, because I think it's the perfect period for the play, where men were men and women were supposed to be housewives. And because I think the whole play is about what's the role of women, what's the role of men in marriage and love and society. So it should be a very fun production. And I think it'll pose a question, who's really the shrew in this relationship, Petruchio or Kate? Then we're going to go to Johnny Cash. We're going to do Ring of Fire, the Johnny Cash musical show.
Big hit on Broadway.
Big hit on Broadway. Richard Maltby did the original. We have the Broadway star who played Johnny Cash on Broadway, Jason Edwards, who was also in Mama Hated Diesels, returning to direct and play Johnny Cash. It will feature four actor-singers and six musicians playing more instruments than you can count. In the Space Theater, another great show for our company, George Bernard Shaw's The Heartbreak House, one of his later plays. It's really a fascinating play today because it has all the Shavian wit and comedy, all these remarkable British characters that you love in George Bernard Shaw plays. But it's interesting because it's about the best and the brightest of British society, both conservative and liberal, both moneyed and not so moneyed, but they can't seem to get it together and deal with the oncoming war, in this case, World War I. The other play is called TBA, that famous American play.
I love that play.
Yeah, I love that play. And it's written by TBA. It will be a new or newish play, either a show that's had relevance and success in New York or around the country, or one of our commissioned plays that we're working on now. We continue to have readings and workshops throughout the year. And I'll be announcing that probably midsummer. So that's the 2011-2012 season.
Thanks for joining us.